this is Rupesh. I'm going to demonstrate you a typical three-phase photovoltaic to grid connected system. This system is developed under the guidance of Professor Vivek Agarwal. So we have a 2 kW PV installation at the roof. It's a DC supply is coming here. So this PV installation is in the form of PV modules. So each module has a 20 volt DC with a 2.5 ampere current at 1000 watt per meter square. So as per our requirement of the DC voltage and current, we can configure those panels in series and such a sets in parallel. So to achieve required voltage at the PV output and the current from the PV system. So this I will going to explain you this power circuit of this installation. That DC supply, as I said, is coming here at the input contactor, and then followed by the input PV bus DC capacitor, then boost converter, then DC link of voltage source inverter, then there are the IGBTs, voltage source inverter. This is the LC, which form LC filter, second order LC filter at the output of voltage source inverter, then to the signal sensing circuit, then to the grid. So apart from this power circuit, it has a control circuit. So that control circuit has a signal sensing board. This control circuit has a signal sensing board which senses the output current and voltages, along with that DC link voltage, then input PV voltage and input PV current. And control circuit involves an intelligent controller, which is a maybe microcontroller or microprocessor or a DSP board. This is a DSP processor, Texas Instrument TMS320 F2822 board. Then it generates the PWM output, followed by the buffer, then driver circuit, which is driving the IGBT modules. Then this is the power circuit and control circuit. So I will going to explain you. So this is that system, as I just explained. This is a PV module, PV panels, which giving the DC voltage and current. This is very raw power. It depends on the radiation level, that is sun status and the temperature, environmental temperature. Then it is followed by the DC to DC boost converter. So this boost converter, we can operate it at the with the MPPT control technique. Then DC link of the voltage source inverter. This is a voltage source inverter. Then L and C, which form second order filter for the voltage source inverter. Then grid side, there is a signal sensing circuit situated which senses the output current and voltage, which feeds to the processor, to microcontroller, to the processor, and then to the grid. So this is the power circuit which is developed here. So this is actually two stage topology. One can develop a single stage topology. In single stage topology, DC to DC boost converter may not be there. So this PV modules or PV system can directly feed to the voltage source inverter. This voltage source inverter then will do the two tasks: one to feed the power into the grid, and one to control this DC link voltage at the MPP point of this PV system. So in that single stage topology, boost converter may not be there. So that may be a high efficient system. But in this two stage topology, this voltage source inverter, it keeps to regulate this DC bus voltage by voltage source inverter. And this DC to DC boost converter, it is operating at with the MPPT control algorithm. The MPPT control algorithm may be a perturb and observe algorithm or incremental conductance algorithm. So here we have developed incremental conductance algorithm for DC to DC boost converter. And this voltage source inverter can be operated with the DC link regulation technique. So this I'm going to explain you a control block diagram of the system. So this is a control block diagram of the system. So as I said, the boost converter is operated with the MPPT algorithm. So MPPT algorithm may be perturb and observe technique, or maybe incremental conductance system. So it takes the feedback from PV system, that is PV voltage, PV current. It takes the product of these two, which gives the PV power, and then it varies the duty cycle accordingly to achieve the maximum power point of the system. So this is the control for the boost converter. Then there is a voltage source inverter. The voltage source inverter control topology is developed with a reference frame transformation technique. The synchronous reference frame transformation technique is adopted to control the voltage source inverter. In this controls technique, we transform all AC quantities like grid voltage and grid the current, grid current, those are in AC. So we transform this grid voltage and grid current into the rotating reference frame transformation. The advantage of this technique is that though all original quantities are in AC, but when we transform it into the synchronously rotating reference frame transformation, it gives a DC quantities for the fundamental components. So let's say there is a VA, VB, VC, which are 50 hertz component, AC component, then we can transform it with a transformation technique like pass transformation, class transformation, then we can achieve the equivalent VDE and VQE component, which preserve all information of the AC quantity for fundamental component. So advantage of this system, this control technique is that though original system is AC, but we can control it using DC component. So it is very, it becomes easy to control the system. Also, it gives the good accuracy compared to conventional instantaneous current control, instantaneous voltage control technique. So in this technique, we have transformed the current, grid current, into the ID and IQE component. Similarly, grid voltage into the VDE and VQE component. Then we are using the PLL technique, because this transformation is possible with the it is actually synchronously rotating reference frame transformation. So for that purpose, we need the information of the grid frequency. So here is the PLL, which takes the feedback of the grid voltages VA, VB, VC. There is a transformation, so it transforms ABC quantity into the VD, VQE quantities, and then from that VQE component can be used to develop this PLL technique. So that PLL technique is also based on the reference frame transformation, synchronous reference frame transformation technique. So other way to develop the PLL is based on the instantaneous power theory proposed by Akaki. In that, we take the feedback of VA, VB, VC, rather than transforming those quantities into the reference frame transformation, there is a control strategy which gives directly sine theta and cos theta, which has the information of frequency, grid frequency. That instantaneous power, the PLL based on instantaneous power theory is very rigid to the unbalances, to the harmonics. So it gives the good result for sine theta and cos theta for the fundamental components. So this sine theta and cos theta obtained from the PLL can be used to transform the ABC into D component and Q component. So once we achieve the ID, that is IDE and IQE, which has a information of ABC, IA, IB, IC, grid current, that can be used for the further control. So as I said, the voltage source inverter is controlled using DC bus voltage regulation. So we take the feedback of DC, actual DC voltage, DC link voltage, we compare with the reference, then through the PI regulator, it gives the equivalent quantity of the active power. So this, it gives the IDE star, that is reference current for the direct axis component of current. So this direct axis component of current is in fact proportional to the active power available at the PV source. So because that, as I said, this DC to DC boost converter is operating with the MPPT control algorithm. So it dumps all available power at the PV into the DC link. So this DC link voltage may tends to perturb. So during that process, this PI regulator comes into action and it develops the active the reference current for the direct axis component of current. So this direct axis component of current is proportional to the active power, and quadrature axis of current, that is IQE star, it depends on the reactive power. So by controlling this ID star, that is active power component, and IQE star, that is reactive power component, we can control the power injection, that is active power and reactive power. So by regulating the DC link voltage, in fact, we are controlling the active power, which is coming from the PV panel, and then we are controlling controlling this ID star to make that actual current ID equal to the ID star, the obtained reference current. We are keeping IQE star, that is a quadrature axis component of current, which decides the reactive power, equals to zero. So at the output of PI regulator, it gives the VQE star and VDE star. So this VDE star and VQE star are then again, these are actually a component to control the voltage source inverter. So again, we have to convert it back to the original AC forms. So as I said, we have transformed original quantities into the DQ reference frame transformation, into the DQ reference frame which is synchronously rotating reference frame transformation technique. Then we have done the control. Then again, we have to come back to our original system, that is AC quantities. So again, this VT star and VQ star, which is the references for the voltage source inverter control, we are transforming it into, again, written back to ABC quantities. So DQ to ABC, it is a inverse of class and pass transformation. So it gives the reference quantities VA, VB, VC for voltage source inverter. Then one can adopt sinusoidal PWM technique for voltage source inverter control, or maybe space vector modulation technique for voltage source inverter control. So we have used here sinusoidal PWM technique for voltage source inverter control. So in that way, by controlling this voltage source inverter, by this reference VD star, VQ star obtained from this control, it actually regulates, it actually controls the active power component of current and reactive power component of current flowing into the grid. As I said, I am keeping reactive power component of current at zero. So this system is operated at unity power factor control, unity power factor, as I said. So one can give the some reference to IQ star here, maybe some 10% or 20% of the equivalent to the active power. Then we can even control the reactive power feed into the grid if required. So this is a typical control circuit of this two-stage topology. In the single-stage topology, what we will do, rather than using a boost converter, there will be no boost converter. So we will regulate the DC link voltage of the voltage source inverter at the MPP of the PV panel. So there we need to control the DC link voltage of the voltage source inverter, maybe with the control algorithm like perturb and observe or incremental conductance technique, so that to achieve that DC link voltage equal to the MPP point of the PV panel. So it is actually a real-time control which controls the DC link voltage equal to the MPP voltage of the PV panel, so as to achieve MPP power from the PV installation. So I have explained the power circuit, it's a control circuit. Then this system, so this system is developed using discrete component only in this lab. So discrete component may be a single IGBTs, or maybe a pair of IGBTs which form a leg of the voltage source inverter. So this IGBT, okay, this single IGBT has gate, collector and emitter. One can use a two IGBT which form a leg of voltage source inverter. People used to prefer this thing. With this special construction, one can keep the distance between collector of the upper IGBT and emitter of the lower IGBT very near to each other. By this special technique, one can reduce the distance between those two, that is collector of the upper IGBT and emitter of the lower IGBT, so that to reduce the path inductance. So path inductance causes voltage spike across the IGBT there. So one is always target to reduce that such a inductances, path inductances. So one can connect a snubber circuit across these two points. So it is collector of the upper IGBT and emitter of the lower IGBT. So it is very convenient to connect the snubber capacitor across these two points. So it is a leg type IGBT. It has two IGBT in this module. So in that way, we need a three IGBT modules. So it will give the six IGBTs for voltage source inverter. So this is major component of this system. Then, as I said, there is LC filter, so inductor and then capacitor at the output of voltage source inverter. It forms a second order filter which gives the minus 40 dB slope of the gain. So it gives the good performance for damping the or reducing the harmonics, higher order harmonics. So voltage source converter switching technique take care of the lower order harmonics, and this LC filter take care for the higher order harmonics. So these are the other two elements of this system. So this is another element of this system. It is Texas Instrument TMS320F2812 DSP board. So it has a resources like PWM, it has resources like ADC, then IO pins. So these are the essential requirement from this controller, from this DSP processor. So whatever control strategy I have explained earlier, which was based on reference frame transformation technique and then boost converter algorithm, that is MPPT tracking algorithms, which is maybe a perturb and observe or incremental conductance algorithm, those can be coded into this processor. So during development process, which one can use such a processor, then after development, one can shift over the cheap processor which is available in market. So I will give you example of such a processor or controller. This is Piccolo controller provided by Texas Instrument, TMS320F28027. So this is a Piccolo controller. Then, so there are other controllers available in the market, like this is microchip TSPIC30F3011 microcontroller. So this controller also has features like PWM, ADCs, and IO pins. The only thing for selection of the such a controller is that it should provide the speed. That is, whatever control strategy we are coding into this processor, it should provide enough speed to execute such a all statement within the stipulated sampling time of the control strategy. I'll explain that control strategy and the instruction set which I have adapted to control this system. The next component is the driver IC for this IGBTs. So just I have explained that the microcontrollers, PWM, you have to provide it to the voltage source inverter. But those PWM is not enough to drive the, or their capacity is not enough to drive the IGBTs. So we have to buffer those signals. Then after buffering, we have to boost up the voltage level and the current capacity of the PWM so that it successfully drive the IGBTs. So this is the one of the IC available in market. It is A3120 driver IC. So one can use this driver IC so to drive the IGBT modules. So we have developed a driver circuit using this 3120 driver IC. So for that purpose, we have to obtain isolated supplies. There are 7 isolated supplies for the in the driver circuit, 6 for the IGBT modules of the voltage source inverter, 1 for the driver, 1 for the IGBT of the boost converter. In market, such a IGBT modules are available. Such a driver for IGBT modules are available. So this is very highly sophisticated driver. It drives the 2 IGBTs of a leg, so that PWM pins, PWM signals can be given to the input port of this driver PCB. So we have to buffer that PWM signal up to 15 volt, and then we can provide it at this port, and it gives the signal for the or PWM for the IGBT modules. So such a driver circuit for the IGBTs are available in market. So it has some features like protection, which it provides the protection against shoot through current for the IGBT modules. This is another element used in this system. It is Hall effect current sensor. So the line current is transformed into the signals using these Hall effect sensors, and then that signal is conditioned, and then one can feed into the processor. So it provides the isolation from the power circuit, between the control circuit and the power circuit. So this is another element used in this system. It is for the voltage measurement. So it takes the feedback of grid voltage, it provides the isolation from at the output signal, then it can be provided to the microcontroller. So all these quantities are in AC. So and the processor adapt only DC signals from 0 to 3 volt. So we have to transform those AC signals at the output, like current maybe up to 3 ampere RMS AC, then voltage maybe 230 volt AC. Those signals can be, we have to condition it, we have to step down those signals, and then we have to use the some filters to further condition to reduce the noise, and then we have to shift those AC signals so that the output signal can be obtained in between 0 to 3 volt range, so that we can give it to the processor. So these are all about the major elements used in this system. Apart from that, there may be other small elements. I had explained you a control strategy, which was based on the reference frame transformation technique. And then for boost converter, there was perturb and observe or incremental conductance algorithm for the control of the boost converter. So these are the control strategies. So we have to code it into the microprocessor. I have used TMS320F2812 DSP processor. It is Texas Instrument processor. So this control, we have to code it, we have to discretize it first, then we have to code it into the processor. So there is software provided by Texas Instrument that I am going to explain you. This is Code Composer Studio provided by Texas Instrument for the debugging, for development of our code. So our code, our control strategy was on continuous time domain. So we have to discretize it into the digital domain. So there are discretization methods like forward Eulers method, backward Eulers method, trapezoidal method, and there are many other methods. So I have adopted trapezoidal discretization method for converting our continuous time domain signals into the discrete time domain signals, like controls of the PI, then filters, then some other signals. So this Code Composer Studio is a C language platform which helps to develop our code for the system control. So as you can see, the main start from this one, there are system controls like that specific to the processor. There is a configuration for the system clock, then GPIO, then PI control, that is address of the subroutines. Then there is PI vector table, the same. Then event manager for PWM, then for ADC configuration, then CPU timers. Then one can use our user-defined functions. Then there are some special instruction for the system preparation. So I'm using two subroutines, CPU timer subroutine, which provide me interrupt subroutine of 30 microsecond and one for 1000 microsecond. So this subroutine, out of this subroutine, 30 microsecond is our critical subroutine. There is a code, just I have explained the control strategy. Those are discretized and coded into that 30 microsecond subroutine. That 1000 microsecond subroutine is our monitor loop. So at the beginning, I'm turning on 1000 microsecond subroutine at the beginning, which check the complete system parameters, whether DC bus voltage is available or not. It forms the communication if anything is there between this system and some outside system. Again, it provides the interface from by the user to the system, like emergency off, like start signal. Then it provides the monitoring signal. So this is outer monitoring subroutine, which is 1000 microsecond. The essential thing in such a system development is that we should have enough resources for the debugging also. During development stages, we need to have information of all variables which is running into the system. So such a debugging thing, such a resources like debugging for the variable signals, like a DAC operation, that processor don't have a digital to analog converter. But we can check the variable or we can check the signals by putting those signals into the PWM pins of the processor. And then by filtering out those PWM pins, we can take out the signal which is carrying by the variables. So this is one of the debugging in this process. Apart from that, this Code Composer Studio provides a debugging tool like graph. So we can see signals available assigned to the variables. Apart from that, this software provides the debugging tools like watch window. There we can check the actual variable or the value assigned to the available in the variable or registers. So there are registers like PWM registers, ADC registers. We can check online our values available in that registers. So this is Code Composer Studio. There we can develop our code. So I'll just explain a critical code in that Code Composer in this software. So at the beginning, CPU timer 1 is start. Then it is actually a CPU timer 1 is a monitoring loop. It starts first. Then if the user provides on signal to the system, it turns on the CPU timer 0. So this is a CPU timer 0 subroutine, which is a critical subroutine where our code control, where our control strategy is coded. So it takes the signal from system, like it is reading the ADC, like output current, voltage, then DC link voltage, then PV voltage, current. After again shifting back into the AC signal, because I had converted those AC signal into the 0 to 3 volt range, then again I have to convert it back to the AC signals. So these are the ABC voltage of the grid. Similarly for current, line currents, then DC link voltage. Then there are filters for the voltages, then current. There is a PLL which gives the system frequency, sine theta and cos theta belongs to the fundamental system frequency that belongs to the fundamental component, that is belongs to the 50 hertz system frequency. Then there is a transformation from ABC to DQ, which is used for the further control. Here is the DC bus voltage regulation. As you can see, those PI is transformed into the discrete form. So I have used trapezoidal approximation technique for transforming those filters and PI into the discrete form. So here is the PI over ID reference component, PI over IQ reference component, that is active power and reactive power control. Then again transform those DQ component to ABC component for voltage source converter control. So this is all about the system development. The Code Composer Studio provides a very strong debugging tool like watch window, graph, then we can use a DAC operation through PWM, and we can develop our continuous control strategy into discrete control strategy after discretization. So this is all about the code development. Now I'll start the system and I'll show you the grid current, voltage and unit to power factor operation for this 3-phase PV to grid connector system. So I'm going to demonstrate you the output current and output voltage from the grid side. So this control technique is very similar to the STATCOM control technique, where we are regulating the DC bus voltage. But rather than regulating DC bus voltage, here we can control the DC link voltage such that it achieves that MPP point of the PV system if it is configured for the single stage topology. In case of two stage topology, we are using a boost converter with a MPPT control algorithm. So I am turning on the system. So this blue waveform is showing the grid voltage. You can see it has some harmonics. At the top of this waveform, you can see the waveform is very tapered. It is because of a non-linear loads used in this premises. So this one is a grid voltage. The one is a grid current, that is current injection from this system. Right now, system is in the off state. So it is taking us current, like a small peaky current at the peak of the AC voltage. So you can see it is also drawing harmonics, or it is also injecting harmonics into the grid. So this is a peaky current. It is because of the anti-parallel diodes across every IGBT of the voltage source inverter. So for demonstration purpose, I have intentionally connected a resistance across the DC link to demonstrate that during a sun is not when the sun is not available or enough radiation is not available, that time the system takes some small amount of power from the grid to regulate the DC link voltage. So this operation is almost like similar to the STATCOM operation. When sun is there, radiation is there, so while regulating the DC bus voltage or while controlling the DC link voltage, that active power of the PV is injecting into the grid. So as I have intentionally connected resistance across the DC link voltage, it must take active power from the grid to regulate the DC link voltage. So I will turn on the system and I will show you that operation. So you can see the blue one is a grid voltage and yellow one is the grid current, that is current injection into the system from this system. As it is 180 degree out of phase, so it means that right now this system is taking power or absorbing power from the grid to regulate the DC link voltage. As I said, I have intentionally connected resistance across the DC link. So now I am turning on the PV, emulated PV, over this system and to demonstrate you the active power injection into the system. Right now there is no PV input at the system, so it is drawing power from the grid to regulate the DC link voltage. Now I am going to turning on the PV input and to demonstrate you the active power injection into the grid. For demonstration purpose, instead of the PV panels, I am using a DC source which will give you a source which will be a variable source, and by controlling this source I can inlet a emulated PV power into the system. I am slowly increasing this voltage. Just look at those waveform. So initially, status was system is this PV to grid control system is taking power from the grid. Now I am inletting PV power into the grid. As you can see, when PV power is not there, that time this yellow waveform and the blue waveform, those are current and the voltage, those were out of phase. That it means that that time it was delivering power from the grid. Now these are in phase. It means that this system, like PV, is injecting power into the grid. You can see, though grid voltage is very, very dirty, like it has some harmonics. I'll show you the harmonic spectrum of the grid. It has some fifth harmonic and seventh harmonic. Because of that, the waveform is tapered at the peak. The yellow one is a grid current, which is almost very sinusoidal. I'll show you, it's a THD. So as you can see, this is fundamental bar, and THD is around 1.6-1.7%, though grid voltage THD is around 3%. So you can see it is injecting very high quality power into the grid. This is a fundamental bar. You can see these are other harmonics, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Those are the harmonics. Those are almost sitting at the bottom. So this was a grid voltage. This is a grid current from the PV system, emulated PV system. Now I am going to turn off the PV system. Again, as I have deliberately connected resistance across the DC link, it is delivering power from the grid to regulate that DC link voltage. Once we turn on the PV injection into the system, it delivers the power into the grid. So now I have disconnected from a DC source which was emulating the PV from this system. Now I connected a physical PV panel to this system to demonstrate you actual physical PV panel power injection into the grid. This waveform is showing, blue one is showing the grid voltage and yellow one is showing the grid current. Right now, radiation level is not enough to inject a full current. Now it is delivering whatever power available with the PV into the grid. So yellow one is showing the grid current injection into the grid current, which is injecting from this system into the grid. So it has small distortion into the grid current because the system is not delivering full rated current into the system. When radiation level is good enough, then that time it will definitely show a good THD into the current. So this is all about 3-phase photovoltaic to grid connected system. Thank you.